Welcome to another Marvel Heroes Monday tweet. Why was I going to say tweet? It's a stream. I mean, come on. It's a stream. We're streaming stuff here. Today is going to be a little bit short. I'm only going to do about an hour long today instead of the usual like hour and a half, 2 hours. And it's still going to be awesome. It's going to be super fun. Super fun. But yeah, I'm talking to like some person here. It's pretty awesome. I'm just sitting here just like, woo! Just typey. Yay, fun. I'm going to do stuff. So for those of you who missed it, on Saturday, I prestige rocket again because I'm a crazy mofo. And I'm basically just going to keep on keeping on and leveling him up. See, look, we got Cosmic Chaos, and it's Midtown Madness Monday. So you guys know what that means. That means that we have to go into Midtown Madness. I mean, it's just the way it is. It's just the way it is. Did you see that? Wait, look, see? I'm Legendary Quest. It was funnier in my head, obviously. But still, it was pretty hilarious, you guys. Y'all are just jealous of my comedic skills. I'm just saying. I'm gonna head back to ICP so I can finish up my fancy things. Hey, look, it's people! We got Revenant and we got Herc. Holla at you guys. How you do? How you do? Danny Hype. Yeah, yeah. Well, what? Danny Hype. Oh, yeah. It's how I do. I'm pretty hyped about me as well. It's pretty awesome. I mean, I am quite amazing. So, everyone should be, like, totally stoked on me. Everybody's super stoked on me. They just don't realize it. Basically Al Gore. But with a cooler haircut. And way better t-shirts. I don't think Al Gore even has t-shirts. What a lame-o. Bow, 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 bow. Pew, 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 pew! Pew, pew, pew! You see me shooting rescue? You see that? I totally won. Well, I hope that you all had at least a halfway decent weekend. After my last stream on Saturday. Like I said, this will be a shorter stream today. Just because I've got like just a bunch of random stuff to do. Today was a busy day and it's not over yet. But I wanted to do my stream for you guys, for the loving viewing audience, because you all are super cool in general, except for Jukacha. He's kind of meh. But no, I'm kidding. He's cool. But like, we got so much stuff to talk about, right? Because like, all the things happen. So, walking on air. Sorry, I had to show off my dance moves. Got food poisoning? Dude, that sucks! Aw, I'm so sorry, Rev. That's awful. Jesus. That is definitely no fun. I am terribly sorry. Is this my Mr. Sinister one? It is. Isn't it so sad? I'm just glad my other one is better. It's not better by much, but it's a little better. I'll take it. I'm walking on air. Could be so free. That is rough, man. I'm really sorry about it. But yeah. That is a pretty rough weekend. And that's what I said. Mine was at least halfway decent, sort of, kind of-ish. But yeah, I got to be here for you guys and all of y'all's coolness, because y'all be super awesome sauce. Yeah, giant. What else was I? Oh, right, we got stuff to talk about. So, earlier today, either earlier today or sometime over the weekend, we had we got the new Apocalypse trailer for the X-Men movie, which was very interesting. And you know, at this point, superhero movies, I honestly don't pay attention to trailers anymore, because they're just full of lies. And I can't believe everything that I see in a trailer. But at the same time, the Apocalypse trailer looked really awesome. It really did. It looked pretty cool. Does that mean that I think it's going to be really good? No, not necessarily. But who knows? And then I read a article over the weekend at some point, or maybe it was like early this morning, where it was talking about the Batman versus Superman movie and essentially saying, was it a success or a failure? Now, in terms of actual box office gross, it made a decent amount of money, but the question is, was it actually successful? And it was kind of a cool article. It was a pretty neat little article. So there's that. There was, what else? Oh my god, this is the other big news. Nobody talk about it. Nobody talk about it. I'm just saying, you better not talk about it. Okay, so for those of you who don't know, this is the theme for Game of Thrones. And I haven't watched it, because the new season started yesterday. So just keep your trap shut. Keep your fingers quiet. Let's see, what else? Yeah, yesterday was okay for me. I got to go out. That was fun. I was like... I went out on Saturday, too. I'm like so cray. The web is dark and full of spoilers. Of course it is. We wouldn't have it any other way. If the web wasn't full of ungodly amounts of spoilers, it wouldn't be the internet. I mean, that's just... We just accept that now. It's just the fact. That is the facts of life. I don't actually know the song, so that's my version of it. My phone went a-buzzin'. It always makes me feel like a boss when that happens. Cause Marvel Heroes just retweeted my tweet about like doing the thing. It's awesome. But yeah, I mean, the Apocalypse thing looks very interesting. Well, just like all the Marvel stuff does. So, well, I mean, we say Marvel when we're talking about Apocalypse. But, come on. It's Marvel. I mean, it looked cool. It looked very cool. I am intrigued. I'm wondering about, what's his name, Wolverine. Because at the very end, they showed, like, maybe it's Wolverine. I heard a rumor that X-23 might be in it. Either in addition to or instead of Wolverine. Who knows? And don't worry, we're not going to rant about the genetic wrongness of X-23. Do not worry. We're not going to go there. Me and my science thing. It's not going to happen. Not today. Maybe when the movie is closer, we'll do it again. But for now, no. Just because I respect you all too much. Yeah, I mean, just... Well, and then, of course, what? Next week? No, 2 weeks. 2 weeks is Civil War. I mean, like, holy... Like, all job of ruining Star Wars, like, in the early 2000s. So, meh. You don't need to have an advanced degree to realize that. But... Well, summer. Where has the time gone? That's not an actual song. I just made it up. I'm sure there is a song that has that lyric in it, but... I'm not aware of it. If I were aware of it, I would be just as bad at singing it. Let's go. comic book science. It doesn't need... And this is very true. Like, that's what it boils down to. And that's why I always tell people, like, as I was getting more and more education in science, it started ruining, like, all of the things that I loved from my childhood. Like, watching sci-fi, like watching Star Trek and Star Wars. Although, to be fair, Lucasfilm did a fine job of ruining Star Wars, like, in the early 2000s. So, meh. You don't need to have an advanced degree to realize that. But, like, at the same time, it's just like, oh, well, that's not possible. This doesn't make sense. Blah, 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 blah. And then I'm just like, oh, I'm not having fun. And I'm supposed to just be having fun. And I feel like that guy. And I really don't want to. I don't want to be that guy. Because that guy's a douche. It's terrible. All right, so here's what we're going to do. We are going to do a Blitzkrieg based based Boss Wave Roulette. So you guys got a minute and a half-ish by the time you hear this to guess what the next Boss Wave is going to be. Just type it in, and if you win, you get a giftable boost of your choice. But, like, just think about it in the game. We got BOGO going on right now. We got the Mega Pack. We got the Advanced Pack, which has come back and is now once again available for purchase. We've got, what's it called? I don't remember what else. We've got other things. The Civil War stuff going on. Obviously, we just got the Scroll stuff with Chapter 10. Like, it's awesome. I mean, I'm glad. I like the fact that we're going in a more content-driven direction this year. Does that mean I'm going to buy the Advanced Pack? I don't know. And Yummy Meat's here. Hi, Yummy Meat. Yummy Meat was the person I was talking to earlier. See, that's Yummy Meat right there. What is this, and why is it so depressing? This isn't Simon and Garfunkel. This is a really you know, this song is already depressing enough without, like, a really hardcore emo depressing cover thing. Okay, fine. This clearly isn't emo, but at the same time, like, come on! This cover seriously is not needed, folks. Let's see, what do we got? We've got Dr. Doom, we've got Magneto, and we'll go with Yummy Meat's guess of the Frightful Four. Oh, see, of course it had to be Sentinels. Yeah, obviously. That's what I should do. I should rewatch Days of Future Past. Wait for me, Cosmic Juggernaut! Oh, okay, well, you can do that. I'm gonna keep going. Vag the Sour. Doesn't that sound like a really, really evil Russian czar? Var the Sour? I'm just saying, it really does. Well, here, let's do this instead. Well, maybe. Let's do a keyword. Here, we'll do a really simple keyword for you guys. The keyword is just X-Men. All capitalized, no hyphen or nothing, just boom, X-Men. You know why? You know why? Because of the movie. Because of the movie, and also because I can't be bothered to think of a clever keyword right now. Because I'm busy fighting Sentinels, obviously, and not typing things into my laptop to say what the keyword is. Hey, look, it's Hugh Jussel. Hello, Hugh Jussel. I don't know what you guys are talking about. I am not opening up loot during the middle of a boss battle or a boss wave. I don't know what kind of terrible, terrible person would do that. But it's not me. Danny, don't roll like that. Danny, do not roll like that. Seriously, now this song is like angry and depressing at the same time. This is like the embodiment of high school emo kids everywhere. No, Hugh Jassel. I will not pronounce it correctly, because pronouncing it correctly is evil and wrong, and it's a mean thing. And you're a bad person. I'm kidding, you're not a bad person. You're just cruel and terrible. In the best way possible. At the very least, I should be able to get to 52, right? I can do that in 40 minutes or so. We got this, guys. We got this. With my purple name. Prince. Still sad. Oh, very funny, Rev. Very funny. Yes, you are hilarious. Aha. Very hilarious. Although I don't see why you're bringing personal computers into this. Ha! Ah! Thank you! I'll be here all night. And by be here all night, I mean physically in the place where I live. I won't be streaming all night, because it'll make my head hurt. I don't immediately recognize this song, but this is another one that sounds really super depressing. Aw, somebody got Beta Ray Bill! That's a cool costume. I don't know. I mean, that reminds me, for whatever reason. It's the... we're getting the upgrade to Unreal, the Unreal Engine. It's not going to be like, oh, whoa, we're still going to have the same isometric format, but we're just like slightly upgrading it, slightly upgrading the Unreal version, essentially. All right, well, you guys got about 20 seconds left to get your entries in for the X-Men keyword or key phrase or, yeah, we'll go with keyword. It makes sense. So get your entries in if you haven't done so already. How is my legendary quest going? Doc Ock! It's perfect. By far, Dr. Octopus, or rather the Sinister Six, is my favorite wave. And you know why? Because there's a whole bunch of bad guys. So they drop lots of fat loot! Loot. Oh, the theme of House Lannister. Okay. That's why I didn't recognize it. Because I was like, I know I've heard it before. It sounded familiar, but I didn't know what it was exactly. Okay. See, I'm not fancy like that. I don't pay attention to, like, the theme song of the person or the people or the... In this case, the house, the hizzle, the family... Etc. What was I gonna do? I was gonna do something that seemed important at the time, and now I forgot what it was. Oh right! After this boss wave, we're gonna do the thing where we push the button and then it says somebody won. So that's very exciting. Very exciting. Let's see. We got Bayidi, and Rooter. Rooter, like Roto Rooter. Sorry. But no, you're cool. You're cool. Hi, guys. Welcome. Or gals. I don't know. You know, it's weird. It's really weird, right? Because, yeah. Words. Math. I remember somebody was talking about that not too long ago. It was basically like misogyny in gaming. Don't worry, we're not going to talk about it because that's like way too deep for my purposes. Especially when I'm only going to be playing for like another 40 minutes. Yeah, no. Linked me something that I found. Ooh. You didn't find a blessed gem of the curse. Wow, that is a fine gem of the curse, though.
Dang.
Very nice, very impressive. I'm jealous. It's mine now. I claim it. I call maritime law. I mean, the internet is basically a series of tubes, which means that it's essentially a series of water slides. Water slides are governed by maritime law, therefore check and mate, that belongs to me. I'm pretty sure that makes perfect sense logically. Pretty sure. Yeah, we'll try. I didn't think that worked. There we go. Yeah. Look at you, you and your Mr. Fancy. Look at me, I'm so fancy. I'm so fancy because I got a fancy, awesome, rolled, blessed gem of the curse, but I'm still saying that this is mine. It's still mine. Wait, what is this? What are you saying? Yeah. The cow is noticeably fascist. I would say we still respect it, but we don't. We do not respect the cow. I'm trying to censor the views. Down with the cow. The cow is trying to take away our right to free speech. Ugh. I wasn't talking about bird law. I'm talking about maritime law. Because series of tubes, water slides, therefore maritime, therefore that gem of the curse is mine. It's very simple. And completely logical as far as I can tell. Just saying. As far as I can tell. To be fair, I'm a doctor, not a lawyer. Darn it, Rooter! I'm a doctor, not a lawyer. Much less a maritime lawyer. I'm not, what's his name? Michael Bluth. Because he's a maritime lawyer, totally. It does not. No, it does not have to. You can have a slide out in the middle of the ocean that's like attached to a trampoline. So check and mate your face, sir. You can have a water slide going down the side of an oil rig, and therefore maritime law. I mean, obviously you can't do it with, you know, like, somebody's personal oil rig, or, you know, one that belongs to, like, a company, but still. I'm just saying. Sharks would eat the slide. Is this Batman? It is Batman. This is a very interesting rendition. Sharks would eat it. Sharks would only eat it if Aquaman told them to. All right, let's roll for the winner here because I'm tired. That's not actually why, I just wanted to roll it. Let's see, and the winner is Bayidi. Bayidi, I'm sorry, I don't know how to pronounce your name because it's really complicated and I'm tired, okay? God. You don't even know, okay? You don't know my life. You don't know what I go through. You don't know what I do to make a good life for you guys. I work 8 jobs, okay? So that you can live the way that you live. Biddy, like MIDI, but with a B instead. So your bassoon instrument digital interface. I got you. That makes sense. It makes perfect sense. Because my brain are smart. My brain are large. My brain are awesome. I was sad earlier today because I tried to apply actual scientific law to comic books, and it made me really sad because I was like, compared to everybody else, like in the Marvel universe, I'm really, really dumb. And it's very sad. But either way, Biddy, you win the cookie. And by cookie, I mean a giftable boost of your choice. So that means that I need to know if you would like a Riff boost, a Sif boost, or an XP boost. And then what your IGN is, your in-game name. So that way I can give it to you. And then you'll have it, and it'll be yours. And then you can, you can do whatever you want with it. You can throw it out if you want. I don't recommend that, but you could. Average IQ is pushing 500. That wouldn't surprise me in the least. It really wouldn't. I mean, it's seriously ridiculous up in this biznitch. No, my boosts! See, this is the boost that Jukercha gave me. Because Jukercha was cool once. He debuted. Why not over 9,000? I mean, might as well, right? Because then we have a built-in reference and it's hilarious. You must be at least this smart to exist in the Marvel Universe. And none of us are that smart. Like, a super amazing child genius for us is, you know, like, an infant in the Marvel Universe. Not only that, but not a very smart infant. Say my name like you mean it. Come on, man. You know we only do that in exclusive chat. Come on, man. This is the public one. Come on, dude. You gotta chill out, bro. You gotta chill out. Hey, look. I can, like, open up all these boxes now. Hey, look. I got a unique. Not that it really matters. I don't meet the requirements to open this box. I bet if I had, like, a blue key or something, it would work. I'm just saying. Biddy hasn't said anything, you guys. We're gonna have to, like, re-roll something in a little bit if we don't hear from Biddy. That's it. Is it, like, Fitty? Does it rhyme with Fitty? Oh, that would be cool. Arr. I'm really tempted to open up my fortune cards, but I don't want to. So, actually, that's what we can do. We'll do the fortune card thing. You guys know what I'm talking about. The Midtown Madness fortune card of awesomeness, awesome sauce. For those of you who don't know how it works, all you need to do is guess what I'm going to get from the Midtown Madness fortune cards of awesomeness. There's all sorts of cool stuff. There's, like, unique items with challenge bonuses, the strong costume core, cosmic ring, the epic team-up gear, the stack of relics, the epic insignia, the chest of 10 Odin marks, chest of 100 Odin marks, the unstable molecule, the random medallion, cosmic medallion, the signet of valor, the random unique item, Midtown Patrol vest, Fred Dawson's cap, and then, of course, the infamous and ever so desirable random costume or ultimate upgrade token. Very exciting. In-game name is Bitey, okay. But which would you like? Would you like the Rift, the Sif, or the XP boost? The rare item find, the special item find, or the just the XP boost? Whichever you prefer. They're all pretty awesome, Sauce. You know, it's so nice not having to worry nearly as much about crafting materials as we did before. All right, after the next boss wave, I'll head back to Avengers Tower. I'll swap out to somebody else, and I will go ahead and open up the fortune cards, and we'll see if we got winner chicken dinner. Alright, well, let's go ahead and get this gifted while I'm thinking about it. Let's see, BYIDI. And a Sith. Oh, is that the Rogue costume? Oh, that one is so cool. And a Sith. You know what, look, Bob Testa is all up in Muspelheim with fancy purple Rocket Raccoon and thinks he's so cool. But you know what? No, it's not cool. It's probably just in a green raid. Doesn't matter. He could be watching my stream at the same time. I'm just saying, I'm cool. Alright, let's see. What are the guesses that we got so far? We've got costume unstable molecules or relic. That's only three guesses, you guys. There's like a dozen things in those cards. Y'all be crazy. We need some more guesses, yo. And I need to reroll my legendary quest. I'm gonna die. I'm too pretty to die! I'm kidding, of course. I am, like, just the right amount of pretty. You know what? Fine. We'll just go to Chapter 8 after we're done here. Fine. Stupid legendary quests. Think you're so smart. Hey, look, a fortune card! Hey, look, shiny stuff! I didn't realize that I had gotten these things. I don't remember hitting Black Cat. Wow. I'm level 49, you guys! I'm so close, I can almost use my ult. I'm tweaking out, you guys, I'm tweaking. Hey, look, it's Dr. Doom. Oh. I know. So, I'm curious. I have a question for you guys. What Marvel movie are you guys most looking forward to in like the next 3 years? I know me, I'm most looking forward to Doctor Strange personally. Not just because it's close, but because it's freaking Doctor Strange and that's awesome. And plus it's Benedict Cumberbatch. So I think that it's going to be really, really good. I'm very much looking forward to it. But I'm curious what you all think. And yes, we'll include, like, the disputed movies like Apocalypse and stuff like that. That aren't, I mean, maybe not technically MCU, but we all know it's MCU. But shh, don't tell nobody. Don't tell them that we know. It's Star Wars! And I got my shirt! Sorry. I know, I ruined it. I know. I'm sorry. That's why I stopped. Guardians Volume 2. Very nice. Also a very good choice. Very good choice. Nice. Very nice. Okay, see? Another vote for Doctor Strange. That's what I'm talking about. Incidentally, the second one that I'm curious about, I don't know if I would go so far as to say I'm looking forward to it, but I'm really curious about Gambit. I wonder how they're gonna, like, do it, basically. But there's a lot of potential with it, essentially. So I know people are very excited to see Gambit on the big screen, like, really see him more properly. Oh my god, a Cable movie? That would be amazing. And you know what, Rudy? You can talk to Revenant and like Jukacha and all those guys, and they'll tell you that I am just this crazy like all the time. This is basically normal for me. Arguably, this is kind of mellow. Just a little bit. I certainly hope. Well, oh, that's right. I remember I saw that, and people were arguing like, who should play Cable? Blah 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 blah. All right, now who should I switch to? We'll switch to Psylocke, just because she was in the, what's it called, in the trailer. And also because she's right next to Rocket. All right, let's see. We've only got a few guesses, but we'll see if anyone wins. You shut up, Rev!
Oh, God. It's like the worst day of my life.
Oh, it was horrible. Oh, it was terrible. Hey, look, a costume core. That's not good. Hey, look, 10 Odin marks. Nobody won! Nobody wins. What was this? Let's see. Costume, unstable molecule, and relics. Nobody won! God, it's like you guys don't care. It's okay. I still respect you all. You convince me that it's logical? No. No. I have to think that there's a good reason to do it. God. Y'all lamos. Alright, so since I am level 49 now, we're gonna head back to the story because it's been a while since I did story stuff with Rocket. Now, did I actually finish this? I believe I did. We're gonna go with yes, mostly because I don't want to do it again. You know, there's a difference between the logical choice and the correct choice. I am not a Vulcan. Logic is not the end-all be-all of my existence. Although it is pretty close. And some people really can't stand it. Oh god, I love leveling Rocket. He's awesome. I mean, I just love playing as him in general because you really don't have to do anything. It's literally just like plop, 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 plop. Ah. And then you're playing the game. It's great. Oh, that's right. I gotta blow up the prototypes. Dang it, Rev. This is true also. Rev has a point because if your axioms are incorrect, then your conclusion will be incorrect as well. Just like you can also have a logical argument that is not sound, which is always the thing. So you can, well, and you can have a sound argument that is illogical. But my favorite example is always the one about penguins, where old TV shows are black and white, penguins are black and white, therefore penguins are old TV shows. But it's a fallacy. Pew, 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 pew! Alright, we're going back for all these stupid prototypes so that we can get the XP, save the world, get the girl. Wait, is there a girl? If there's not a girl, then I'm not interested in doing this anymore. See, this is why I need a Miss Brevik. Or just one of my friends. I don't care. Just somebody else sitting here doing stuff. And, like, just sitting here and helping me out. And, you know, having witty banter. I mean, Jukacha's okay with witty banter, but meh. Squirrel Girl. What about Squirrel Girl? Squirrel Girl is ridiculous and makes no sense. Just in general, she makes no sense. Pew! Let's go fight MODOK. Oh baby, let's go fight MODOK. Let's go fight MODOK. Oh baby. And yes, I do still have the black cat grappling hook. Why? Because I'm amazing. You all may feel free to be jelly. Oh god, no! That would be, god, can you imagine me sitting here and then like every once in a while she's just like, I'm just like, oh god, shut up!
Oh, that'd be terrible. And then she sends a bunch of squirrels to bite me and I'm just like, ow, rabies!
At the very least, it would be entertaining for you guys. And in the end, isn't that what really matters? Yeah. Yeah. Oh, God. Squirrel Girl is the most powerful being in the Marvel Universe because she defeated Thanos. Ooh. It's so dark and brooding. Be the best stream ever. See, I told you, at the very least it would be entertaining for you guys. Alright, let's go ahead and get another keyword started for you guys. Alright, because we're going to go and visit our good friend the Mandarin, this will be the keyword. Actually, I don't feel like typing all that out, so we'll just go with the simple one. Plus, this way I can have the excuse of having everything in capital letters. Alright, so the keyword now is Hydra, all capitalized, because Hydra. Hydra is awesome, and totally not all up in the business of any sort. And this will be the same thing. This will be for a giftable boost of your choice if you win. I'll go ahead and do the drawing probably after I'm finished here. Hail Hydra. That's it. Rev is the traitor. Rev is the traitor. Everybody saw it. That's a game joke for you guys who don't know, because there are board games wherein you have traitors. And one of my common tactics, and just basically to have fun, is that I will always just say, everyone's a traitor, because it's just hilarious. Is it counterproductive? Obviously. But more so it's hilarious. And therefore, I do it. Thank you for your cooperation. If you guys are wondering, these weird trailer cart things are the power generators that the thing refers to. The Legendary Quest. And you know, I still wonder how it is that people in, well, I guess it was the Winter Soldier, right, where it really came out. That, like, all these people are in S.H.I.E.L.D. and, like, they're constantly talking to each other and they're just like, Hail Hydra. And it's just like, you know that, like, Jim in accounting one day is just going to be like, oh, you say something, boss? No, I didn't say nothing. I don't know what you're talking about. Hail Hydra. You know, it's like, now, boss, come on. I know you said something. And then they're going to have to kill Jim in accounting. Like, what the fudge? These people just are not very smart. What is this? Is this chopsticks? This sounds like chopsticks. Mm-mm-mm-mm. You know, fun fact about this song is it's actually a waltz. You can actually dance to it. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Come on, everybody, waltz! I actually don't know how to waltz, but if I did, I totally would be. Although, I wouldn't waltz with Squirrel Girl, because that would be just weird, and I don't want to. Alright, let's see. We've only got 3 entrants into our Hydra keyword giveaway here, guys. Come on, y'all gotta get all up on the ball. That sounded very, very wrong. But you all know what I meant. Why am I so awesome and only me? What do you mean? Did I say I was awesome? I didn't mean to. I mean, I am pretty awesome, but still. But I am confused by the question, and also I plead the fifth. We need more evaporators. I thought I got more evaporators than that. Yeah, because they're like the big tanks. I guess there was just like those few that were like gathered together. There we go. Yay! I did it! Like I said, after I defeat Mandarin, I will go ahead and do the giveaway for Hydra. See, Rooter has the right idea. How hilarious would that be, where we get an inside look at Hydra, and then people are just like, Hail Shield. And it's like, wait, what? Who said that? And it's just like, what? I don't know what you're talking about. See, that's what I want to see. I want to see Marvel movies from the bad guy's perspective. That'd be awesome. If nothing else, then just to give Robert Redford more screen time. I don't know what this is, but this sounds very brooding and scary. I feel like I'm in Bayonetta, and one of those big, giant, weird angel things is about to attack me. I mean, what's his, like, Robert Redford could have gotten a lot more time, and then, God, I can never remember the actor's name. The guy who plays Red Skull, and he's, like, in everything. He is in, like, every single nerd movie in existence, but I can never remember the guy's name. Oh, crap. Ah, this is gonna bug me now. Hang on. I told you this is gonna bug me. Hugo Weaving, that's the guy's name. Okay, somebody probably already said it in the chat. Agent Smith. Yeah, exactly. Agent Smith. That guy. Oh. Wait, what? Ender's Game. Ah, yes. Ender's Game is absolutely amazing. Without a doubt. We'll go ahead and do a giveaway here. Why am I so good-looking? Wait, are you talking to me? Because I am bad-looking. I am... I am terrible looking right now. Just saying. Well, who's that? Somebody did a thing. Tink Vader. Ha ha ha. Awesome name. Tink Vader, thank you so much for the follow. Why am I so good looking? I think it's probably the beard, right? Yeah. Oh, yeah. Men want to be me. Ladies want to be with me. Actually, it's completely untrue. I made myself sad. I was going to do something important. Right, we got to roll for the winner. And the winner is Rooter! Congratulations, you are the winner! And that means that I need to know what your IGN is, your in-game name, and then I also need to know which of the three boosts you would like, if you would like the Rift Sif or the XP boost.
Yay!
I'm scared of what's going to be next now. Oh, this is trippy. Really? Who put this in? Who put this in? They're out. They're out. They're near. Oh my god. I remember this from Winnie the Pooh when I was a kid. It freaked me out the first time I watched it. So weird. If you all have not seen it, if you haven't seen it, then they are referring to elephants and weasels. But seriously, the animations for this are really creepy. I highly advise against taking any sort of psychoactive drug before watching it. It is truly frightening. So freaking creepy. But no, seriously, this, like, the visuals that go along with this is like Fear and Loathing in the Hundred Acre Woods. Like, no joke. It is really trippy. It's freaking weird. Ha! See? Take that, Jukacha! Somebody likes the fact that my inventory is all messy and nasty. So, that's what you get. People appreciate how awesome I am. Ooh, see how ugly it is? Oh, it's like I don't even care about society's norms. It's like I just let entropy rule my life. But seriously, guys, if you get a chance, watch the actual video for this song, because it's really weird. And don't worry, Rooter, I will be gifting you your shiny just after I'm finished with Dr. Doom here. I just want to get the, I want to get the shiny XP because it's shiny and it's XP.
Size.
So does this mean that we're going to start like a creepy Disney song thing now? Because that's weird. I mean, we've had a lot of strange themes musically on this here stream. Oh, see, this is a fun one. Everybody, come on.
Bare necessities, forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities, which is recipes.
Speaking of, has anybody seen the new movie? Have you guys seen the live-action Jungle Book? I haven't had a chance to watch it. I want to see it. But if you guys have seen it, like, is it cool? Is it interesting? I'm curious. I don't know. Because I'm not one of these fancy people who can just drop everything and go to the theater. Or rather, the cinema. I will say the cinema. Pew, 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 pew. Necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities. That's why a bear can rest at ease with just the bare necessities of life. Now when you pick a paw, ooh, Civil War premiere. Ooh. Big money. And you prick a raw paw. Well, next time, beware. That is true. Bears can indeed climb much faster than they can run, and that is scary as all get out. And have you seen the pictures where it's like somebody holds up like a bear paw next to their other hand, and the paw is like this big? And it's just like, I mean, bears are seriously scary. They are death machines who just want to destroy all that you know and love. Like, that's pretty much what it boils down to. They really are pretty terrifying. I don't have a particular fear of bears, but if ever there's an animal to be afraid of, it would be a bear. Like, no doubt. Kid, we've got to get to a tree. This calls for some big scratch. I don't know what I'm doing. Wait a minute. I didn't get... Oh, shoot. At some point, I must have gotten rid of my level 60 thing. Well, wait, no. Well, crap! That sucks! I got rid of my level 60 minigun. At some point. Wow, that's really, really frustrating. Dang, that's annoying. So just try. Let's see. Relax. Yeah. Cool. Fall apart in my backyard. Because let me tell you something, little britches. If you act like that bee, if it's a grizzly, it'll knock the tree over and eat you instead. And don't spend your time looking around for something you want. See, in Sweden, you got wolves. See, this is why I don't go outside. People are just like, Danny, you should go outside. It's fun. It's great. Just like, no, it's not. Half of the stuff out there wants to kill me, and the other half wants to eat my corpse. I'm just saying. I give up. Well, I hope his luck holds out. Ugly, how about you, sir? That is true, too. The ocean is really scary as well. All right, I'm gonna clear out Odin's palace real quick, and then unfortunately it'll be time for me to go. I do still owe Rooter the shiny. Don't worry, I haven't forgotten. Mostly now, I'm just like really sad that I got rid of my minigun. That's really frustrating. Dang. That's just fudge. That's annoying. Oh, well, I mean, what are you going to do, right? So sad. Oh, what's this one? It's another Jungle Book song, but I don't recognize it. Did I forget to turn in? Did I fail? Oh, that's right, I forgot Heimdall. I need my PowerPoint. You know what? I don't really care about Heimdall anyway. He failed at his job, so whatevs. Why should it matter? See, look, 72 points. And now, whabam, still 72 points. It's all about the XP. It's all about that thing, about that thing, about that XP. It's all about that XP, about that XP. Yeah, my thing here, the minigun, my unique item, when I prestiged Rocket, all of my stuff went into my inventory. But the problem is, that thing is gone. Because, like, see, I've got my slot 1, I've got my slot 4, I've got my slot 2, and then I got my slot 3. But I don't have my slot 5. I don't know where it went. That's really annoying. Oh, you don't need to do these. Those aren't necessary to fly through. Oh, no. Yeah, it's not in there. Yeah, I just didn't realize that it was something not to get rid of, and I accidentally got rid of it. I imagine it might be in my stash for Rocket. It might be. We'll see. We'll take a look. But nah. This is a really creepy stalker song. But no, see, it's not in here. I knew it wasn't because everything was in my inventory. But that's really unfortunate because it was good. It wasn't the best. It wasn't like maxed out, but like I had it with like all the good stuff. Not that that's difficult to get, but still. It's unfortunate. And Rev's over here judging me. One, I got my number 2 and number 3. And then I got my number 4. But my number 5 isn't here. I don't even have one. Like, I have literally gotten rid of all of them. I am that bad. Something important, and now I forgot what it was because I was dancing. Tends to happen. Let's see here. Nope, not in there. This is basically where it would have been otherwise. So yeah, see, I got my number 1. I got my number 2 and number 3. And then I got my number 4. But my number 5 isn't here. I don't even have one. Like, I have literally gotten rid of all of them. I am that bad. Alright, well, with that, I gotta get going, unfortunately, because I need to eat, and then I got some work to do, unfortunately. So it's very sad. Look at Yummy Meat! Big Daddy Yummy Meat with the Max Omegas. What? And I owe Rooter. I did not forget. See? I are smart. See, it's just I was so sad. Alright, let's see here. Rootamus. Oops. I'm Danny and I can spell. Rootamus. R-E-W-T-A-M-U-S. Why isn't it working? You know what? I'm gonna get rid of Doom Song. Cause this is just weird. Science can't make nobody smarter than nobody else. Okay, here, let's just try this instead. Okay, you're already on my friends list. That's why I'm so confused. Okay. Alright, so gifty, and an XP boost for... Man, look at all these people with their fancy cosmic prestiges. Aw, see, that's what I'm talking about. You got that Doctor Strange fear itself. Ooh, I love it. I love the Doctor Strange fear itself. Yay! There you go. All right. See, so since you got it, we're going to swap out real quick. Just so you guys can see, because it's super awesome. But yeah, unfortunately, that's it. So yes, the matter, you got here a little bit too late, because today's an early night, unfortunately. So see, Doctor Strange Fear Itself costume. Absolutely amazing. He looks so cool! You know, I should shave so I have that like Fu Manchu like thing going. Or I guess it could be like Outlaw Biker, but still. I totes gotta get me some of that. He looks freaking awesome. Alright, but either way, with that, thank you guys so very much for being here. I am sorry for the early night, but unfortunately, like I said, I got a bunch of random stuff I need to do tonight. But I will be here on Saturday for my at the usual time. So hopefully I'll be able to see you all there. It's very exciting, very fun stuff. I don't know that we'll have new big things, but if I don't finish Rocket during the week, which I probably won't, then I'll finish him on Saturday with the Purple Prestige. But with that, I'm going to get going here. Thank you guys so very much for being here and all the interesting music choices. It's always a fun time, and it's always so random seeing what you guys put in. But thank you very much. Take care, have a wonderful week, and I will see you on Saturday.